Dean Stevenson, distinguished scholars, it's a privilege to be here today to discuss such worthy research endeavors, and I thank you for considering my proposal. In my dissertation, I'm exploring the interactions between and influences of British feminists and Indian feminists from 1929 through 1938. Specifically, I analyze how British feminists and feminist groups interacted with their Indian counterparts during the interwar era, and how in doing so they articulated differing feminist agendas. I investigate these interactions with regard to five key events: the Child Marriage Restraint Act, or SARTA Act, Gandhi's Salt March, the Roundtable Conferences of 1930 to 1932, the publication of Eleanor Rathbone's Child Marriage, the Indian Minotaur, and the Government of India Act of 1935. The 9-year period of study allows for analysis of three questions. Precisely, what changes in interactions and alliances took place between groups and individuals working on feminist causes? How or why these changes occurred, and in what variation? Of particular interest to this project is not just how British feminist groups influenced Indian feminist groups, but how Indian women influenced their British counterparts, thus contributing to change in British government policy. Additionally, British feminists and Indian feminists disagreed significantly regarding the sublimation of Indian feminist goals to the interwar Indian nationalistic agenda, making this germane to my analysis as well. These topics, then, marry ideas of gender and empire during Gandhi's ascension as the leader of Indian nationalism. British feminists and Indian feminists espoused very different priorities in the interwar era and saw conflicting paths to achieve their goals, especially concerning the relationship between nationalism and feminism. Both Minnie Sinha and Harold Smith note that the singular feminism is too confining in that it assumes a universal feminism that applies to all women regardless of class, race, or nationality. Most British feminists, however, assumed the idea of a singular transnational feminism to be true. Thus, many adopted a paternalistic stance toward their Indian sisters. Indian feminists, however, did not pursue most closely the immediate attainment of Western feminist goals, but instead saw their identities aligned with the nationalist movements within which their Eastern feminist ideologies found a home. Thus, in relation to the British feminists, Indian feminists rejected their counterparts' paternalism as an extension of empire. In other words, Indian feminists did not see men as their primary oppressor, but rather viewed colonial rule as the yoke from which they needed to escape. Understanding the transnational interactions between these feminist groups will help us identify how differing knowledge and power structures shaped feminist ideas across the interwar British Empire. My thesis demonstrates that the transnational feminist interactions between British and Indian activists also worked to revise ideas of gender roles in governance and society in interwar Great Britain. In addition, I argue that these exchanges altered the content of how feminist groups in Britain petitioned Parliament and shaped how they interacted among each other. This is of crucial importance to our understanding of the political interactions of British feminists in the interwar era, for no research has yet been done on how ideas of and interactions with empire has helped establish both alliances and discord among feminist groups. My academic work of having earned 4 master's degrees, having multiple publications on interwar British cultural and political history, as well as my advanced work on modern South Asian history, provides me with the background necessary for this project. As well, my humanitarian aid work and travel in 48 countries has given me firsthand understanding of the ongoing fallout regarding issues of empire. Moreover, I benefit greatly from the wise counsel of my outstanding dissertation committee members, including my advisor, Dr. Susan Kent, a renowned historian of modern Britain and gender issues, and Dr. Minty Mukherjee, our superb scholar specializing in the legal, political, and gender history of South Asia. Dean Stevenson, distinguished scholars, thank you for your time.